This is a set of data on captopril and its use for lowering blood pressure that comes from the book Applied Statistics. What you have here is the systolic data, blood pressure before, systolic blood pressure after, diastolic blood pressure before and diastolic blood pressure after. As well as that, I've done some calculations of the systolic difference, so the difference between before and after, and the diastolic difference between before and after. Now, if you look at the differences, they're all negative. So we already have a suggestion that this is going to be a significant difference between before and after, and the captopril is having an effect. Now, this was carried out for 15 patients. So you've got the measurements for those same individuals, and so you can't use an independent samples t-test. You have to carry out a dependent samples t-test. So now you go to compare means and you go to paired samples t-test. So in this case, you pick systolic blood pressure before, systolic blood pressure after as the second variable, press OK, and that's the result of your t-test. So here, the test statistic set is 8.123. I've got 14 degrees of freedom, which is the 14 pairs, 14 patients, minus 1, 14 pairs of measurements, and I've got a significance value, a p-value of 0.000, so again, it's below 0.002. So this is saying that the difference between the measurements before and after is significant, and the confidence interval for the difference is from 13.9 to 23.9. That's quite a quite a large difference, and a mean difference of 18.9. That was for the systolic. I can do exactly the same for the diastolic. So if I go to analyze, compare means, pair samples t-test, in this case I do diastolic before and diastolic afterwards, press OK. I can see that for the diastolic, it's also significant, though slightly less significant than in the systolic case. Here the difference is between 4.5 and 14.03. But in both cases, there's a highly significant difference produced by the drug. Now there's one other way that I could have done the paired t-test, and that's why I calculated the differences, systolic differences and diastolic. So the null hypothesis is that there's no difference between the two. So if the mean differences, so the mean sys diff or the mean diastolic diff was zero, then there would be no difference between the two groups. So I can do what's called a single sample test. If I go to one sample t-test, I can do diastolic and systolic, comparing them against a test value of zero. So if the mean difference is zero, then there's no difference between before and after. If the mean difference is not zero, then captopril is having an effect. So if I press OK on those, I again end up with the same p-values, the same significance values, the same size of my t-statistics, so one was 8.123 and the other one was 4.166. This time they're negative. It depends on which order you put them in, whether you have 0 minus the difference or 0 plus the difference, or the difference minus 0. And confidence intervals is minus 23.9 to 13.9. Here it's 13.9 to 23.9, so they're exactly the same result. You can do it either way. Compare the differences to a hypothesized difference of 0, or compare the before and after using the paired t-test.